Hey everyone, welcome to Moving Matt. We do all things cameras with a dash of vlogs and a little bit of travel. And today I'm going to be giving you my predictions of what I think the Sony A7 IV will have as far as specs go. So I've made this type of video in the past, but it has been a while. And since then, we supposedly have had some reliable leaks that's came out of Sony Alpha Rumors that's given us a clear picture of the specs. So I figured I'd refine my predictions now that we have a little bit more knowledge and we're closer to the release date. So I'll start off by saying that I believe that the Sony A7 IV is going to be a very impressive camera. The Sony A7 III was very impressive in its day, and I think that the specs are going to be quite a bit more aggressive than what we've been hearing other people predict. But before we get into the nitty-gritty of the specs, I will first start off with the body and the predictions that I believe about the body. Now, personally, I think we'll have the same body and ergonomics as the Sony A7S III. It will have the same flip screen, of course, but I do think they'll be adding the shutter drop when the camera is turned off, kind of like they have in the Sony Alpha 1. That protects really well against dust and moisture from getting into your sensor when you take off your lenses. I think it's been a great feature in Canon for a while now, and I suspect it to be coming to the rest of the Sony Alpha cameras, starting with the Sony A7 IV. Now, a little bit more information that's kind of in the body category. I do believe that the screen that is going to be on it is going to be a new screen. I think they are going to go with the same screen that they are now putting in the Sony R4A and the Sony R3A. It looks like the screens that they've had in the past are kind of running a little short on production. That's why they updated them to make a camera in the first place. So going along with supply issues, I think they're going to be using the same EVF that is in the Sony R4, and they're not going to be using that 9 million dot EVF that is found in the Sony Alpha 1 and the A7S III. That is going to be a differentiating point between this camera and those super high-end cameras. But that 5 million dot EVF is also excellent. And if I'm not mistaken, I believe that the Canon R5 and R6 are somewhere in that 5 million dot EVF range as well. Now, going a little deeper, I think that that screen is going to have the new menus that have been found in the A7S III and then the Alpha 1. I do not think that they're gonna be adding any more additional touch functionalities, which I wish they would, because the Canon menus and the Canon functionality with the touchscreen is much better in my opinion. But that being said, the Sony A7S III menus are a huge update over previous Sony cameras, so at least we'll have that. So now that we got some of the ancillary things out of the way, according to Sony Alpha Rumors, this will have a 33 megapixel sensor. And since it has a 33 megapixel sensor, people have been speculating, well, how fast will this actually shoot? People have thought, well, will it actually go with the 12 frames per second and the 20 frames per second electronic, like what the Canon R5 and R6 are offering, or will they slightly dumb it down, considering that the A9 Mark II offers that same speed? Now, personally, I'm a slightly torn on this. I do think that it is possible that they bring it down slightly, maybe to the 10 frames per second with the 18 frames per second electronic, because I guess they could differentiate and say, hey, we have a 33 megapixel sensor, where the R6, which is our direct competitor, has a 21 megapixel sensor. Now, personally, I actually don't think they're gonna cut it down any. I think you're gonna get 12 frames per second along with 20 frames per second electronic. And the reason I think they're gonna be able to do that is basically just chalk it up to that's the way technology has evolved. The A9 Mark II will almost be 2 years old when this camera comes out. They've already had the Sony Alpha 1 that has kind of replaced it. And we do not know if they're gonna actually be doing an A9 III. And if they are, then that's gonna replace the A9 II as well. So I really don't think they have to worry about competing with the A9 II. Also, if you look at the A9 II, it was very incremental update from the A9 in the first place. And it was really just a placeholder because they thought that the 2020 Olympics was actually gonna happen at the time. And we all know what's gone on in the world since then. Besides that, I do think that the Sony A9 will have a much faster sensor when it comes to readout and rolling shutter. So that could differentiate itself as well when it comes to sports photography. But I do not see them crippling what is probably going to be their most popular camera to protect a camera that is almost 2 years old now. And also, I do not think that they like playing from behind. And if Canon is doing this, I think they want to do it as well. Now, moving over to the video specs, which to me personally is the most important specs. I actually differentiate myself a lot from other people as well, because most people are saying it is just going to have 4K 60 and they're not going to try to get anywhere close to what they've done with the Sony A7 S3. They don't want to step on the Sony A7 S3 toes at all. I don't really think that that is the case. Now, I do think that 4K 60 is probably going to be the highest that they go as far as frame rate options in 4K. But that being said, I do think they're going to have something a little bit more special than just 4K 60. I think they are going to go with 6K in this camera. Now, what leads me to believe that they're going to have 6K in this camera is they've been downsampling 6K in the Sony A7 III for a while now. So for them to have actually 6K in this camera would be a big deal. Now, a lot of people think, well, how would you add 6K to this camera and only have 4K in the Sony A7 S3? Well, again, I think it's just the way technology evolves. I do think the Sony A7 S3, for whatever reason, was maybe delayed by a year or so. It seems like they had pretty much all the specs locked in. So for them to have this technology ready to go already makes sense to me. And also, if you look at the current situation, the A3 does downsample from 6K and 4K. So in that way, the resolution is already better than the Sony A7 S3. Now, I do also think that this will be 10-bit, and I do not know if it will be 10-bit 422 or 10-bit 420. Not exactly sure on that yet. The other big question for me is if they're going to be going with the 6K, which I believe they will. Will they have it as a full sensor readout, or will they crop in? If I'm not mistaken, it will be somewhere in like the 6.7K range with a 33 megapixel sensor. I could be wrong. We'll leave it to like a tall Canadian to do the math, but it will be somewhere around that range. So it would be hard for me to believe that they're actually going to be downsampling 6K from 6.7K. That sounds ridiculous to me. It's possible. But my guess would be that they will actually just be cropping in slightly to give you that 6K image, maybe it'd be like a 10 to 15% crop. Now moving over to the 4K, 4K 60 will be the high end 10-bit as well. Will that actually be downsampled from whatever the 33 megapixel sensor is? So say 6.7K, for example, and somebody can correct me down in the comments. Now, the other option I think they have is to have the 4K 60 pixel binning, kind of like they did with the Sony Alpha 1. The 120 was actually pixel binning. So that's an option. But again, I don't think they like to play from behind. And if the Canon R6, which is almost a year old now, is offering, I think it's 5.1K downsampled 4K 60. Even though it's a slight crop, I personally think that Sony wants to outdo them, and it's been a year of technology later. And I do not think that Sony wants to put this camera as a cookie cutter camera. I think that they want to establish themselves as the best value camera that you can possibly get. And I think 4K 60 HQ, I will call it, would be the thing that really impresses a whole lot of people, along with that 6K title. Now, I do not think they will have record limits set on this camera, but I do think it will be possible for this camera to overheat some. It will have a very good cooling system, kind of like what's in the Sony Alpha 1, the A7 S3, but they still have possibilities of overheating. So I do think that they will have some overheating issues, and they will be forthcoming with that in the 6K mode, as well as whatever the 4K HQ will be. And in that case, they will probably have some form of 4K pixel binning that pretty much does not have any overheating issues whatsoever. And going along with that, I believe this will have the full HD at 240 frames per second. I kind of think that that's not surprising at all and is what they're going to go for. Now, the other supposedly reliable spec that we got from Sony Alpha Rumors is it will have 5.5 stops of in-body image stabilization plus have the active stabilization. That sounds right to me. It makes sense that they would try to push it up just slightly. I think the dynamic range is going to be awesome in this camera. It might be similar on par with the Sony A7 S3. They may allow the Sony A7 S3 to have a slightly better dynamic range in kind of order to differentiate it. I think it will have great low light as well, at least as good as the Sony A7 III is right now, which is pretty excellent. I don't think it's going to be as good as the Sony A7 S3. I think that that is their big low light draw camera. so I don't think it's gonna be quite as good as that. Now, of course, there's more to a camera than just these specs, but this video is getting a little bit long, so I will just go with those predictions as highlights. And I wanna open up a conversation in the comments. Let me know, do you think I'm crazy? Do you think this is way out of the picture? Or do you agree that it's gonna be something like this? Drop in the comment section below and give me your list of specs. And if you've liked this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing. And until next time, peace.